Hey guys, in this video we're going to look at copying and pasting XML code to Excel and back into your form editor. So what am I talking about? First of all, let's open up Excel. And you will see, if we select multiple questions here, this handy little help menu comes up, talking about copying and pasting questions. So what actually happens when we copy paste a question? Well, we're actually copying the XML code and then pasting it back into the form editor. So when we select one question, for example, the label question, we press Control C, we go to our Excel file, we press Control V, we can actually see the form builder in action. So we actually see the XML code here. So what does this all mean? Okay, first of all, we have the ID. So this is just simply the ID, what it looks like in our file path, right? So we have introductory message. It's not in any question groups, so we just have / introductory message. Then type is trigger. In this case, that means label. Then we have the actual display text. So that's this big long bit of text, and then an appearance column. So let's try another one. Let's try, for example, copying this entire group. So Control C, I'm going to just put it in A1, Control V, and let's just make this a little bit smaller. Okay, what do we have now? Again, we have the ID. And here we see, you know, a bit of a change. So first of all, it tells us there's a group. Then within the group, we have a text question called project in the ID. And in the display text, project. Then we have some additional columns that we didn't have at first. And this required attribute. The required attribute tells us whether or not a question is required. So, you know, I can... Again, if I put my cursor in A1, I press Control A to select all, Control C, I can copy the initial assessment record back into my form editor. And there we go. And obviously now the question ID is going to come up as copy one of, because we already have it in our form builder. But this is a really handy way to export the questions that you have in your survey in kind of this like raw format, so you can see the data behind the questions. And for example, if I want to make large operations, if I want to change my survey significantly, for example, I want to make all of these questions unrequired. So instead of having to go through each question unselecting required, what I can simply do is just make all of my required values null, select all of it, paste it in, and then delete the original. Okay, so we have a little exercise that we can do. As you might have noticed, they have a question here in the form for the camp settlement, and obviously also a GPS coordinate. But what we don't have is kind of a breakdown of, well, what district is it in, what county is it in, these kind of things. So let's imagine that we're doing this survey in Jordan. Now, what kind of administrative zones do we have? So Jordan has two administrative divisions. The first is governorate, and the second level is district. So this is how it works. We have Al-Karak, which is this. This is the entire governorate. And then within Al-Karak, we have multiple districts. So how would we set this up in ComCare? Well, first of all, we would set up a multiple choice question with each of the governorates. So Ajlun, Al-Aqaba, Al-Baqa, etc., etc. And then for each of the choices in our multiple choice, we would create a separate question with the districts. So there would be a multiple choice question called Ajlun, with these two districts as the options. And same for the rest of the governorates. So there is actually an easier way of doing this, and that is called a lookup table. But we won't be discussing that in these videos or in this module. That'll be in the advanced ComCare module. And in additionally, in the free version of ComCare, you cannot use lookup tables. So we're just going to stick with the old way of doing things. Now, in your materials, there's a folder called XML code that actually contains the XML code for all of the exercises that we did. But there's also this folder called Country Form Builders. And if we go into the Country Form Builders, and we scroll down to Jordan, we open it up, we see the CSV file here containing all of the governorates and districts in Jordan. So it's already been done for you. And these kind of like country form builders exist for every country. We've auto-generated them at Go. So if you're doing any project for any type of country, you simply just open up the CSV file, copy the data inside, so copy the code inside, and then you can just paste it into your form builder. So let's try it. So we've opened up the Jordan Excel file. I'm going to press Control A, Control C. I'm going to go back to my form builder. The only caveat is that we first need to paste the country form builder in the base of the form. So we cannot paste it inside a question group. We have to paste it in the base, and then we can drag it into a question group such as this initial assessment record. So let's just paste it. So I clicked on the label, the first label, by the way. Okay, it's going to give us a warning that it discarded Spanish and French. That's fine. I'm just going to click this away. And great, so now we have our folder. It automatically... So these are hidden values that automatically check which of the level 2s and level 3s, which Jordan doesn't have actually, which of the level 2s have been selected, and it's just going to put it in here. So you don't actually have to worry about the responses of these. So that's our selected administrative level 2, selected administrative level 3, where there is one. And then here we have the governance. So that's our administrative level 1. So in your export, these are the only three responses that you'd really need, or the three variables that you really need, and you can kind of forget about the rest. But how does it work? So here we have our governorate with all of the different options. And so if I select, for example, Acaba, then it's only going to show the options for Acaba. And if your country has a third administrative level, then you know whatever you select here will only show up in administrative level 3. For Jordan, it automatically gives you a text value with a default value of not applicable. So if there is an administrative level 3, then you can just add that here. Great, so hopefully you managed to do this okay. Let's just collapse. So I just collapsed Jordan here. And then we can drag this anywhere. Maybe we want to do it after the project, right? And then do all of the country stuff. So the question ID will just come up as country. And then after identifying, you know, in which governorate and district it is, we'll do the facility. So what does this look like in our ComCare application, you might wonder? Well, let's have a look. So again, we have our first question with all of the governorates. So if we select the first governorate, Ajlun, it then gives us the districts for Ajlun. Were we to select Amman, it gives us the districts for Amman. And then it asks us for administrative level 3, which might not be applicable. So then I can just press continue. And then the facility name.